Hi everyone and welcome back to another video with me Shruti Vashisht. You're watching Living Our Ascension. So this video is going to be this week's reading for all of us. You're going to get messages from our guides, messages from the stars is what I used to call this reading. But essentially they're messages for ascending souls, guidance for ascending souls for this week. So before we get into the reading, I just want to let you know that below this video you can find a couple of different links. One of those links is to work personally with me through Skype or Zoom sessions. Another link is to a self-study course that I have, which is called Manifest Soulmate Relationships. There's also a free course that you can check out, a free mini course. So all of those links will be below this video and you can find them there. And for this week, as always, just choose either number one, number two, or number three. And once you have done that, you can scroll through and just find your number and you can listen to your message there. So if you chose number one, then we're going to pick a card. And you get this one. We're using the Inner Child deck today. I really like this deck. It's one of my favorites. Have like these fairy tales and archetypes from them. Okay, so this card, it's the Pied Piper, but what I'm really feeling from this is as soon as I look at this card, there's just so many colors in it, and there's all of these fairies and they can't listen to his music. It's kind of like too loud for the very first one. That's what it looks like if you look here. So I really feel that this is a message for you to not give up, you know, not raising your voice, but what is that? You have to keep shining your light. You have to keep speaking your truth. And because you can see that he is so happy, look at him, like he, there might be some people that are protesting or that are, you know, not fully in alignment with what he is saying, but they're still sort of drawn to his music. It's like they kind of like confuse themselves, but he seems pretty clear. Like some of them are completely on board, some are a little bit, you know, they like it but they don't like it, and they're in that state, mental state, whereas he is just in flow. So that's what I feel for you right now, that you are in flow. So let go of that fear that you have of not being accepted, of people disagreeing with you in some way, or of just not, it's kind of like you are coming into a new level of power, and you can't care what people think at this time, because it's more about truth. It's more about knowing what is right and shining, you know, that authentic light of yours in the world, and creating that music, you know, that is authentic to your own vibration. So whatever this is that you're doing, whether it's your work or advice that you're giving in relationships, or the truth that you're speaking in your relationships, it's coming from a genuine, authentic place. And so you're not supposed to let go of that truth, and you have to embrace your power instead, because this is what is, look at how many followers he has. He's like drawing it in. So this is how everything is being drawn to you, whether they are people, all of that will come, but first you have to hold the vibration. So don't be deterred by those one or two things that you see in the outer world where somebody is disagreeing with you and stuff, because that can be more of a mental energy. And when we feel that mental energy from others, sometimes we wonder if we are out of alignment, but this message is saying that you're not. So I hope this message resonated with you. Let me know in the comments below what you thought of it. And I'll see you very soon in the next video. So if you chose number two, then we're going to pick a card now. And this is the one you get. So I think this is Alice in Wonderland, and this card is the Wheel of Fortune, which is a really positive card. It means that something is coming to completion, and let me just have a look at it for a second. So as I look at it, there's just so many characters in it, that they're looking at different things, like they have different faces on, like they have different moods or something. There's this queen. and then, you know, this guy, they have different expressions on their faces. It's not like they're in synergy or anything. And I noticed that Alice is looking at a book that is on the ground. It's lying on the ground. And I feel that she's found that missing piece. Like, so far, she was trying to align everything and balance everything out in more mental ways, you know, that how is this going to come to be? This is what I want for my life, for the next chapter in my life, because this is the Wheel of Fortune card, which refers to a completion of a chapter and entering into a new chapter, which is very significant now because we just had the eclipse. Actually, the eclipse was today as I'm filming this, on the 5th. So, but it's almost like, and I didn't even think of a chapter, like it's a book. So she can see now what's in this next chapter. She has entered that next chapter, so it's now visible to her. So she has clarity. So before, she was trying to mentally put things together. What should I do? And you know, she was looking for answers, but now it's like it's right in front of her because she has stepped into it already, and she has stopped looking at all of those other physical factors like people or situations in her physical life that are more of a mental, at a mental level. And this is just occurring in flow. It's like suddenly there's a book lying there with the answers on it or something. So she has entered that, she has embraced that. And I feel that there's a completion that's happened for you. This is especially relating to something that's been testing you for the past 2.5 years, because Saturn was some astrology that I'm going to speak a little bit about now. But Saturn, this planet of trials and tribulations, was in different in a field of your life for all of us. So in some part of your life, it has been quite tested for the past 2.5 years. And if you have picked this particular message, then it has come to a conclusion, completion. So these tests, like, you're done with them. So you need to know that about yourself, because we create what we believe. So if, as long as you are still holding yourself in the old, that, you know, my relationships were happening this way, they're going to happen the same way, my career was happening this way, it's going to be the same, then you need to let go of that, because actually those trials have ended and you have come into this new maturity that's there. It's like this new level of wisdom. So what you're going to create will be quite different as well, and you need to know that. So stop looking at all of these mental things around and what's in the physical world, and, you know, all of these proofs in the physical world that something is not happening, because it's here for you. You've actually entered it, and tap into how it is here now, because it's actually all around you, and you will actually know what this new chapter is for you. You have stepped into it already, even if you're not seeing the actual physical everything lining up. The energy is here. It started to be created. It's blossoming already. So it's taking shape. So I hope that message was helpful for you. Let me know in the comments below what you thought about it, and join me again in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed to this channel, and give it a like if you liked this message today. If you chose number 3, then we get this one. Let's see. Wow, it's a really pretty card, huh? Okay, let me have a look at it. As soon as I look at it, I'm seeing, you know, the instruments, the violins that these little fairy beings are playing. And it's like an energy of spring that's there. And I feel that things are getting lighter for you, because there are lighter colors around. The colors of light blue and lilac, they relate to these more spiritual colors. It's kind of like, you know, when we shift from that more heavy healing phase into a lighter phase where, you know, the things are transforming, but we're not holding on to them. We're not experiencing it as this intensity. It's more like, yeah, it's just there. You know, this is my nature. I'm a butterfly and I'm beautiful. And whether I'm a caterpillar or I have all of these wings now, doesn't matter. I'm still beautiful. So that is how you are feeling, and everything is in harmony because there's music. So it's all in harmony, and because of this, there are relationships coming to you, because you see here, they're all playing together. they're all must be in the same tune, because look at this card. So they're all in harmony, and their souls almost, you know, are attuned. They are in harmony, in resonance, and when they come together, they create beauty and they create harmony. So this can be a time where, because of this lightness that you're feeling, because you've come out of a slightly heavier period, but you're seeing it as this lightness, even if there's still some transformation happening, you're not experiencing the intensity. So because of that, it's time to play now, because there's play inside of you, and you're drawing to you different people who are in resonance, and there's just this beautiful light energy that's there. So music might be helpful for you right now as well. Any kind of creativity, really. And it's so funny that this card has come up, because just today I was thinking about making a video of myself singing on my Instagram, because I've actually learned singing, you know, years ago, classical singing, and I don't sing that often. So it was like, I had this deep desire to start, you know, seeing myself, which I was wondering which songs should I do, and what do I feel like, and then this card has come up. So I really feel that this is a time that this is how you are coming together with others. There's like this energy of play and coming with others and having a good time, and not only just working, whether that's working on yourself through inner healing or whether that's working like your career, but you get to have this more playful time as well. So that's the message for you this week. Enjoy, and let me know if it resonated with you, what exactly you are creating, and subscribe to this channel if you're not subscribed. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you liked the message today, and I will see you in the next video.